يا حامل القرآن قد خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان والروح والريحان. يا حامل القرآن قد خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين، فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه أبداً أبداً. اللهم أحينا على سنته وأمتنا على ملته واحشرنا في زمرته، اللهم وأوردنا حوضه ولا تحرمنا شفاعته، اللهم كما آمنا به ولم نره فلا تفرق بيننا وبينه حتى تدخلنا مدخله. ثم أما بعد عباد الله، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي رسول الله، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار عياذا بالله. وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم واخشوا يوما لا يجزي والد عن ولده ولا مولود هو جاز عن والده شيئا، إن وعد الله حق، فلا تغرنكم الحياة الدنيا ولا يغرنكم بالله الغرور. أيها المؤمنون، إن الله سبحانه وتعالى تبارك اسمه وتعالى جده ولا إله غيره، خلق هذا الكون فأبدعه، وخلق الإنسان فكرمه. اصطفى الله سبحانه وتعالى آدم من بين خلقه فأسجد له ملائكته، ورفع قدره وقدر ذريته، واصطفى الله عز وجل من خلقه الكثير، فاصطفى من الأيام، واصطفى من الأماكن، بل واصطفى من الملائكة. ثم إنه سبحانه قد التفت إلى بني آدم، فاصطفى منهم نوحا ومن كان معه، واصطفى من ذريتهم إبراهيم وذريته، واصطفى من ذرية إبراهيم بني إسرائيل، ففضلهم على العالمين. ثم إنه سبحانه وتعالى اصطفى من بني إسرائيل آل عمران، واصطفى من تلك الأسرة المباركة مريم عليها السلام، فكانت مطهرة من بيت طاهر، اصطفاء من اصطفاء، رباها الله سبحانه وتعالى وأنبتها نباتا حسنا. كانت يتيمة تربت بعيدة عن أمها وبيتها، فشملها الله برعايته لتكون أما لكلمة الله وروح الله ورسول الله وآية الله ورحمة الله، لتكون أما لعيسى بن مريم عليه وعلى أمه السلام. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا ممن يؤمنون به حق الإيمان، ويؤمنون برسله لا يفرقون بين أحد منهم، وأن يحشرنا يوم القيامة مع هذه الكوكبة من المصطفين الأخيار. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. We're talking today about the messenger of Allah, the ruh of Allah, the word of Allah, the son of Maryam, Isa alayhi salam, the person that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared his mother for his arrival. Why we do this today? This is the method of the Quran, is to correct the misguidance and to put things right and to say it loudly. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did. This is the truth. ذَلِكَ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ قَوْلَ الْحَقِّ. This is the speech of the truth. Anything else is false. Anything else is fabrication. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose Adam from his creature. And then he chose Nuh alayhi salam and those who followed him. And from their offspring, Allah Azza wa Jal, out of His wisdom and unlimited power, He subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to choose Ibrahim and his descendants, and He made the prophethood and the wisdom in that noble lineage. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the family of Imran, and Allah Azza wa Jal protected the daughter of Imran, Maryam, who was born orphan, who grew up away from her mother and her home. She grew up by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who raised her up to be chaste and pure. That young girl who was there, excluding herself, devoting her life to worship Allah Azza wa Jal. The angels spoke to her in different occasions. She got used to that. She was addressed by the angels talking to her. She was provided by Allah Azza wa Jal directly. Even those who were close to her, like Zakariya alayhi salam, the prophet of Allah, he himself was astonished to see that there is food with Maryam that he did not provide himself, and that was provided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The angels spoke to Maryam and told her the fact that she was the best ever woman who walked on the surface of this earth. They told her, Ya Maryam, Allah has chosen you. Allah has purified you. Allah has selected you over the women of the world. They told her in another time, Ya Maryam, there is a good news for you. You are going to have a son. His name is Isa, the son of Maryam. And they told her, his name what is going to happen in his life. They told her what is even going to happen to him in the hereafter. Can you imagine the greatness of that woman? The angels came to her and spoke to her before she was even pregnant. And they told her, you are going to have a child. You are going to have a son. And this is his name. This is his description. This is his fate in this life and the next. She asked a question just because she wanted to know. It's not because she rejected that. Like Ibrahim alayhi salam, her great-great-grandfather, who said to Allah, أَرِنِي كَيْفَ تُحْيِي الْمَوْتَ. My Lord, show me how you bring the dead to life. She asked a question, how can I have a child without having a relationship with a man? I'm a chaste woman and I've never been touched by a man. How am I going to have a child like this? According to the limitations of this life, the physical laws that Allah created for us in this life, this was impossible. But Maryam was reminded, and we need to remember at all times that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not limited, and His power is not limited, and His will azza wa jal is not restricted by these physical laws that we have in this nature, because He is the creator of all of this. He said to her, قَالَ كَذَلِكِ قَالَ رَبُّكِ هُوَ عَلَيَّ هَيِّنْ وَلِنَجْعَلَهُ آيَةً لِلنَّاسِ. We will make him a miracle or a sign for mankind and a mercy from us. And this decision has been already made. In Surah Al-Imran, they said to her, Allah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not like that. When He decrees a matter, He just says, kun, be, and it is. Allah Azza wa Jal orders something that doesn't exist to come to existence. Subhanallah, it is even difficult for us to fully comprehend this. Allah gives an order to something that doesn't exist to come to existence, and it does come to existence. And Allah told the angels, told Maryam, that your son will be taught the book and the wisdom. They told her, your son will speak to people straight away after his birth. She came to her family with a baby on her hands. When they saw her, they said, Maryam, you've done something so evil. What is this? You've let us down. We never thought this about you. And then she pointed at Isa. She pointed at her son, the baby. It's like saying to them, ask him. And they said, how can we ask a baby who can't even say anything? And then Isa alayhi salam spoke. He didn't even speak baby language. He spoke as clear as what he said when he was old. يُكَلِّمُ النَّاسَ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَهْلًا. He speaks to people when he was in cradle, exactly in the same way that he speaks to them when he was mature. What did he say to them? This is the statement of Isa that is hidden. Those who say that today is the birthday of the Son of God, they never say that he spoke in his cradle, because he said, Inni Abdullah. I am the slave of Allah. The first thing that Isa uttered, that Inni Abdullah. He repeated that throughout his life. He was always confirming this fact to his followers and to his enemies. Inni Abdullah, I am the slave of Allah. Atani al-kitaba wa ja'alani nabiyya. He's given me the book and he made me a prophet. وَجَعَلَنِي مُبَارَكًا أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُ. and He made me blessed wherever I am. He ordered me to pray because I am His slave. I am created by Him. I am a human being. I have orders from my Lord. I have to fulfill my duty. Part of my duty is to prostrate before Him. أوصاني بالصلاة and الزكاة and to be good to others around me, to purify myself and to give my hand to others. Throughout my life, وَبَرًّا بِوَالِدَتِي, and He never forgot to say that He made me good with my mother, dutiful to my mother. And in this statement, Isa alayhi salam is confirming again, I have no father. He did not say, I am ordered to be dutiful to my parents. He said to my mother, وَبَرًّا بِوَالِدَتِي وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْنِي جَبَّارًا شَقِيًّا وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيَّ يَوْمَ وُلِدْتُ وَيَوْمَ أَمُوتُ وَيَوْمَ أُبْعَثُ حَيَّ. This is all in Surah Maryam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed mainly. That surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed mainly to refute the fabrication and the lie and the insult that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begot a child. At the end of Surah Maryam, Allah said, أَنْ دَعَوْا لِلرَّحْمَانِ وَلَدًا وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِلرَّحْمَانِ أَنْ يَتَّخِذَ وَلَدًا. It is not befitting for Allah to have a child. إِنْ كُلُّ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا آتِي الرَّحْمَانِ عَبْدًا. Everyone in the skies or on the earth are all surrendering themselves before the Most Merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala. Isa alayhi salam came to this world with miracles. The first of them, that his birth, he himself is a miracle. He himself is a blessing. He himself, his existence, his birth is rahmah, is mercy to people. He came to make the religion easier. He came to make things more practical to them. He came to remove some restrictions or burdens that the children of Israel suffered or struggled with for many years before that. Isa alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him to do things that were more relevant to their time. They excelled in medicine. So Isa alayhi salam came to cure those who were born blind. How? Without any medication, by just wiping their hand over their eyes, and then here you go. They open their eyes and see again. He cured those who had vitiligo, the skin disease, by wiping his hand over their skin. And then they are cured by the permission of Allah. بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ, as Allah said. More than that, above all of this, He brought the dead back to life. Imagine that you have someone who's dead and you call the ambulance and the ambulance come, the person is pronounced dead. Said, okay, we'll try to bring them back to life. Wipe the hand and the person is back to life. That was the power given to Isa by Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. أُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. And he used to tell people about what they store in their homes and what they do in their private lives. عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ. Isa عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ, the messenger of Allah, the son of Maryam, the miracle, the word of God, was never crucified nor killed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him up to him. He was elevated to his Lord. Allah saved him from those who disbelieved, from those who rejected him and wanted to crucify him and kill him. Subhanallah, how bad these people were. Allah sent his beloved messenger through this miraculous way in order to guide them and make their life better and easier, and to tell them about more better regulations, and to free them from other things that they themselves put on their shoulders. when Allah sent that mercy to them, this is the way they received the gift of Allah. This is the way they received the guidance, by plotting to kill the messenger of Allah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him. And Isa is going to come back. He's going to descend on earth at the end of the time. And this is one of the signs of the Day of Judgment, that Isa will come down. Isa alayhi salam will come down to tell everyone, I am Isa. I am the messenger of Allah, the son of Maryam. I am here to rule by the religion of the last messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's going to spread justice. And he's going to spread monotheism, worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal, breaking the cross and killing the pig, as the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide all humanity. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to guide His slaves to His true religion. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us to spread the guidance and the light. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us mercy for those who are around us, like Isa alayhi salam. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us mercy and guidance for everyone around us. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to guide people away from this fabrication and this lie. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be patient and kind with humanity who insult Him today. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them and to guide them. Allahumma inna nas'aluka ridaaka wal jannah wa na'udhu bika min sakhatika wa min an-nar. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-huda wa al-tuqa wa al-afafa wa al-ghina. Allahumma ahdina wa ahdibina wa ja'alna sababan liman ihtada. لا إله إلا أنت لا إله إلا أنت لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت الأحد أنت الصمد أنت الذي لم تلد ولم تولد وليس لك كفوا أحد اللهم إنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت نسألك في هذا اليوم العظيم المبارك أن تغفر ذنوبنا وأن تستر عيوبنا وأن تداوي مرضانا وأن تشفي جرحانا اللهم إنا نسألك أن تفك أسرى مأسورينا اللهم فك أسرى مأسورينا اللهم تول أيتام المسلمين وأراملهم ومساكينهم وضعفاءهم اللهم إنا نسألك أن تأذن لدينك أن يسود اللهم مكن له في الأرض وافتح له قلوب العباد بفضلك ورحمتك ومنك يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم إنا نسألك أن تغفر لأموات المسلمين أجمعين اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وعافهم واعف عنهم وأكرم نزلهم ووسع مدخلهم اللهم تجاوز عن زلاتهم وضاعف في حسناتهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ومصطفاك محمد وعلى الأنبياء والمرسلين أجمعين وعلى الصحابة والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما
خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان والروح والريحان يا حامل القرآن قد خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان.